Fellow comrades, ladies and gentlemen, my fellow Southern Cameroonians, welcome to yet another edition of the MK the Southerners Corner. This is a program produced by the State House aimed at letting you to know the true story as far as the Cameroons are concerned. To let you know the extent to which you have been colonized. It is a program focused on casting out neocolonialism from Africa, because the Southern Cameroons or the Amazonian Republic has been colonized for too long by the Francophone La République du Cameroun. Before we proceed, ladies and gentlemen, join me in thanking God, because for 13 years since I had my first child, Kavi Willis Miriam, God blessed me yesterday with a bouncing baby boy, whom, as Africanist as we are, we named him Kavi Kallen. Kavi, no English name, no John, Peter, Paul, or whatever. As Africanist as origin. Ladies and gentlemen, once more, welcome to the program. Our pineapple for today, Gobina, say, sorry. Man, where you don't die, you know the fear coffin again. Die body, you know the fear coffin. So, the Southern Cameroons youth, I'm addressing you today, especially the most educated elite, because I see sometimes like the worst thing to have happened to Southern Cameroonians youth is for them to have been educated. Because I do not see what they do with the kind of education they have. Many of them, they have all the affixes that you put before any name. The PhDs, the doctors, the reverends, and what have you. Yet, they don't know that there is nothing else for them to lose. There is nothing else for them to lose that they have not lost before. There is nothing else, I repeat, for Southern Cameroonians youth to lost that they have not lost before. Because since we joined La République du Cameroun, we have been systematically drained economically, politically, religiously, physically, mentally. We have lost everything. There is nothing more. Yet you see educated Southern Cameroonians youth here in Europe, moving from one PhD program to another. Some of them have 4 or 5 PhD in different sectors of education. Just to renew their documents to stay here in Europe with PhDs, with those good affixes. Don't think that they stay here working in an office or in a big NGO or so. They're in the farms. They're mopping houses of people without advanced level equivalent here in Europe. They're going around the street sometimes like mad people. But when you talk to them, they fail to understand that they have their land, the Southern Cameroons, that has been colonized by the Francophone La République du Cameroun, who sends their children to take all their jobs, who employed only their children, who gives secure all the places in all educational institutes in the Cameroons for their children. Yet, when they struggle and come here, they don't struggle to fix a place better for them or their children. Let us take for example that we have succeeded in sending this neo-colonialist regime of La République out of our country. The Southern Cameroon's population is 6 million people. That is enough. That is enough, but not enough to fill all the jobs, all the vacancies that will exist in a free and fair Southern Cameroons. I was not very good at math, but when it comes to the Southern Cameroons situation, I will try the best math I can. Okay, let us see, look at it this way. The population of the Southern Cameroons is 6 million people. Let's say 1 million of these people are employed in the seaports, airports, or let's say the transport sector takes 1 million of Southern Cameroonians in the Southern Cameroons, not in La République du Cameroun. Then we are left with 5 million people. Let us say 1 million of these people are employed in the Sonora, the oil refineries, the CDC, marketing boards, etc. Let us put it that the mining and agricultural sector takes 5 million of these people. Then we are left with, let us say it takes 1 million of these people. Then we are left with 4 million people for the rest of the jobs that will be available. Let us say 500,000 of these people works in the Cameroon Bank, the Southern Cameroon's Bank, the Treasury, the Taxation Department, etc. Let us call it the Finance Department, that it takes 500,000 people. Then we are left with 3,500,000 people. Let us say 500,000 people out of these 3,500,000 people are old. They are both working age. They cannot work again. Then we are left with 3 million people. Let us say out of these 3 million people, the military wings, let us include, let us say the soldiers, the forest guards, the warders, the marines, the police, let us say all of them, let us just say they take 1 million people, then we are left with 2 million people. Then for instance, let us say, the other department, we are left with 2 million people. Let us say 1 million of these people that are left are underage. They are still students, toddlers. They cannot work, really. They are below working age. Then we are left with just 1 million people. Let me ask you, where will most of the civil servants come from? What about the private sector? You will notice that it will be foreigners, people from La République du Cameroun, especially our neighbors from Bunda, that will be running to the Southern Cameroons to do odd jobs. They will be coming, struggling behind your sisters and brothers, your daughters and sons, just to have documents to stay in the Southern Cameroons. Our territory is just enough for us to manage. In a free and fair Southern Cameroons, I'm telling you, the educated and not non-educated citizens of Southern Cameroons, that you'll be able to put food on your table, that you'll be able to make that marriage wedding you're waiting for, that you will be able to take care of your sick aunt, dad, uncles, fathers, whatsoever, who are depending on you, that you will be able to go about proudly, to tell somebody that I'm a Southern Cameroonian. To football lovers, I will tell you that in a free and fair Southern Cameroons, you'll be able to support a country you know is from your soul. That you know that this player, this is their house there. This one, I grew with him. This one is the son of this person. Not calling foreign francophones people who play and earn their monies only in their francophone regions, and you are turning the Cameroon. That is total crap. You are an idiot. It baffles me that Southern Cameroonians even support the team more than the francophones and even fight over. When you ask them how many of them have been playing there since the conception of this unholy union, they cannot even tell you because they don't know. That if you are counting, it's not up to 15 since 1961 till date. Southern Cameroonians who have passed through that hell of a national team. But yet, we have our own country. It doesn't mean that if Southern Cameroon succeeds today, We will not have a national team. We have players, but they cannot be seen because they are not needed. We have young guys in the Southern Cameroons who are not where they are today because there was no motivation. Before a Southern Cameroonian tried to do what, tried to get into the national team, there is just this, their backdoor and corrupt practices that they go. We will not have that in the Southern Cameroons. When you merit it, you have it. For how many years, Mukake was the best player of Cameroon, but was never called for the national team, until when he succeeded and something happens, that they remembered that there was a player like this. Young Sport will take the Cameroon Cup. Best players will be given to them. But when they'll be calling local best players home to join the so-called national team, they don't remember that there was a best player there, there was this person. There is just no motivation. But in a free and fair Southern Cameroonians, our children are playing, we are watching, and we are making the selection. Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Southern Cameroonians, this struggle is a struggle not to miss. Please get in now and write your name in this history in the making. Your family name is most important. We need you. You need us. Your country needs you. Stand up and be counted. Go sit back in your house and ask yourself, so what do I do with this education that I have? If you go back to La République du Cameroun, sorry, you have nothing. Because even the so-called Commonwealth, which is supposed to help us, the Southern Cameroonians, it is their children. Go to. You'll be surprised that if you go to Britain today, most of children who are there out of Commonwealth scholarship are Francophones. They take the Francophones, they take the Francophonie scholarships. We are left with nothing. We are rubbish. But if we have our country that we manage ourselves, you will not be identified by their language. I struggled some other time in 2008. I told some of the students, I wasted my money. I said, okay, let us start calling Cameroon embassies all over the world and speaking, but in English. We tried. They were arguing with me because I was telling them that most of them will tell you stories that you end up being angry. We called so many and we spoke in English. We called about four of them, and three told us Cameroon was bilingual. If we cannot speak French, then they are sorry, they cannot help us. And when we insisted, they said, not Cameroon est bilingue. Tu dois parler français. And from there, seven of those guys who were in my house are going over till date. They found out the truth. Two did not. Until when they went home, one went home and something happened to him that he will never forget in a hurry. Don't wait for something to happen to you before you see the truth. Then you must be as greedy as anything. Like I said, Southern Cameroons have lost more than the fear they have now. You have lost everything, so there is no need to be afraid. In the situation of Southern Cameroons and La République, there you have nothing to lose if Southern Cameroons move away from La République. You have nothing to lose. Those who are supposed to be afraid and struggling to convince us to stay are Francophone youth, are La République du Cameroonians. So if any Southern Cameroonian youth stand up today to defend La République du Cameroun, or to say, oh, Cameroon is one man, let's leave that thing, he has a mental problem, or she has a mental problem. Thank you very much for watching. If you did enjoy the program, why not join me next time, same day, next week. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, and stay blessed.